Yo, what's going on, guys? Wait, I'm gonna go. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. JJ, Eytan, you guys here?
Yeah. How's it going?
Yo, it's doing great. What about you, Eytan?
Good. Thank God. Doing awesome.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm glad to be part of the show. Hey, Zack, it's me. Hey, Eytan.
Yo, JJ, what's happening, man?
What's happening? Okay.
Yeah. Good to see you guys. All right. Welcome back to Good Shtick with Zack, episode 5, live from Burnfield, New Jersey. My name's Zack. I'm here with our featured guests, Eytan Arie, resident advisor, and JJ Goldstein, live from the Five Towns. We're going to be discussing several important issues, such as getting involved with Yachad, importance of doing chesed during Corona, and some general info about the Makor program. If you got any questions, we're going to take them at the end where you can raise your hand, and you're going to get a chance live to ask them to us, and we'll be more than happy to answer them. So I just thought I'd do a quick... I was like reading some funny memes about good pickup lines that you could be able to say to people if you like want to, you know, try and get woo the person over that are Corona related. So here's a couple quick fun pickup lines. So number one, if COVID-19 doesn't take you out, could I? And then number two, since all the public libraries are closed, I'm checking you out instead. And number three, you can't spell virus without you and I. And four, that mask really brings out the beauty in your eyes. And five, you smell so good. Is that Purell you're wearing? All right, whatever. I've had enough of my – I thought they were funny.
I like them. Zack, I like them.
It means a lot to me, man. Okay. These are the – if you wrote them down, that's great. If not, I could definitely post them, whatever you guys want. Up, oh, some people liked it. Thank you, Molly.
Yeah, you're getting a lot of positive feedback.
I'll take it. Okay.
We have more feedback.
All right, let's just get right into it, guys. So I just wanted to ask you guys a quick question. I'm also more than happy, as me, Eytan, and JJ all actually did Masor Yachad together a few years ago.
Yes, we did.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, I'm wearing the shirt. I don't know if it sees. Yep, you guys can see. Whatever. So just wanted to ask you guys, like, when – and why did you guys first get involved with Yachad back in the day?
I'll start.
Let's go for it.
Back in the day, I started in Yachad when I was 11 years old. That's like 15 years ago. And I love Yachad because I love going out to Sabbatonim and to Yabi Yad. I did Yabi Yad 2012.
What was your first program when you started Yachad? You did Shabbatones, or you did
my first program? I did. I went to Yabi Yad in 2012.
Wow, nice. Eytan, what about you?
Very good. So I actually got involved in Yachad kind of as an accident.
Oh wow!
I got dragged along with one of my friends. Basically, when I was in ninth grade, I wasn't really involved at all. I didn't really even know what Yachad was. And then one of my friends decided to go on the Yachad Leadership Shabbaton. Yeah, which happens in October every year, which is, it's a really awesome Shabbaton for those of you who haven't been on it. Highly recommended for next year. But one of my friends basically just said, like, hey, it'll be a good chill. Come on, let's go. It'll be a fun weekend. And I decided to go. And I guess from that moment on, my life kind of has gone in that direction, if you want to say. I went on Yad Biyad, which I guess is one of the topics for later, which we'll talk about in a little bit more detail. But I went on Yad Biyad, and I guess from that moment on, it was, I guess, history.
Cool. All right. So I guess I'll just tell my story quickly. Back in the day, I did the Masor Ropes course, and you know, it was, I had a great time. And then one Shabbos, I just kept hearing all this hype about circle time, and I was like, "What circle time?" So decided to check it out, and it was pretty much just like an hour of shtick. Like it was just like games, singing, and like it was a lot of ruach, a lot of fun, and I was just like, and like I just like fell in love with it was just a great atmosphere of like a lot of positivity. So I started going like every week, and then I was like, you know what, I'm gonna, like, I loved running, like, whatever, I still do love running. I'm on the YU cross country team, so I decided, but back in TBC, I was on the TBC track team, so I decided to go for the Jerusalem Marathon, and it was like definitely a life-changing Shabbos. Like me, I was too. Like the youngest person. Oh yeah, you were there 1 year. Me and
yeah, I do like every year. I go to Jerusalem, I got Miami too.
JJ, we were. Do you remember we were at the Jerusalem Marathon together? We roomed together that 2 years ago. I think it was.
No, it's not true. Never happened.
Did happen.
Oh yeah, sure. Okay. Whatever. So yeah, so I did the Jerusalem Marathon. Obviously, Eytan and JJ were apparently roommates. I don't know why I was invited. But
so now we're roommates.
sure. Whatever makes you guys. Okay. So whatever. So I had a great time. And I was like, and then I like in June, I heard that like Mr. Yachad was still recruiting for boys. So I was like, you know what? Something I got to do. And I decided to switch my summer plans and did Mr. Yachad. And definitely best month of my life. Really, really awesome time. So I just wanted to ask you guys, what was
fun fact before Zach goes on to the next question? Fun fact: Zach is one of the best. He's one of the best circle time leaders I know.
Yes, yeah, so no. Here he is. And that's true.
Eytan, you want to explain circle time?
Yeah, basically, circle time is this amazing activity that we usually do, both on Friday night and on Shabbos day at Yachad Shabbatonim, or we do it at different camps that have Yachad within the camp. Basically, everyone comes into one big circle and like kind of surrounds a middle, and someone goes inside, and we have a bunch of cheers or songs or different games that we play. So one of the games that Zach kind of took over in Minnesota is something called Pizza Man. He could tell you a little bit about it, but he had a whole costume and a whole setup.
Oh, yeah.
And he even coined one of the phrases. It was really fun to watch him always.
All right, basically, it's all about rhymes. So like, you know, like I'm Zach Snack Pack in a kayak with Jack and Zach and Shaq on the track. That's whack. So like, whatever. So Pizza Man, like you just want to do everything that rhymes with Pizza Man. So like, I try to incorporate Disney with that, but then also like you could go like Michael Jordan. So like, whenever I did Michael Jordan, I'd go whoosh, and then like the whole place would go whoosh. Apparently, they still do it. I don't know.
It was a fun time.
I really love that.
Yeah.
And you can see our swag here. I mean, Yachad swag here.
Wow, that's a lot of Yachad swag.
Yeah, this is all my keepers. I've been my Yachad keepers. And also, I have an army. This is the Yachad one. These have it at $25. You can go on the website.
You got it for $25?
Yeah, $25.
Wow. That's sick.
Yeah. If you want one of these, go on the Yachad website. And it's like $25.
It's all about the swag.
It's all about the swag.
It's all about shtick and swag and having fun.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Want to know, what was your favorite Yachad experience program that you guys have been on?
JJ, you want to go first again?
Eytan, go first.
I should go first? Okay. Hands down has to be Yad V'Yad, both as a participant and as a staff member. Basically, Yad V'Yad, for those of you who don't know, it's Yachad's Israel summer experience for high schoolers post 10th grade usually is the age. And it's a fully inclusive program that goes around Israel and does everything that a normal mainstream Israel summer program can do. So like we go rappelling, we go on different hikes, we go rafting, we go to the Kotel, we go to different museums, basically just like any other mainstream program would. And it's really such a life-changing experience. Like it's a leadership program. So kind of people kind of start to feel comfortable. Everyone's accepted, everyone belongs, everyone kind of feels more comfortable in who they are, and they kind of step out of their comfort zone and become into much better people like as a result of the program. So I think that for me as a participant, it kind of very much like made me who I am. And as a staff member, like there's just so much better just being able to be there for my participants also. It's a really special program.
KJ, what's been your favorite program that you went
through? My favorite programming is I like to go to Yabiyad. I did it in 2012. I let them go. I did Yachad events. I go to the ball party. That's in St. Island, you see. And I did the New York Yachad. I did that.
Wait, you did a Super Bowl party? A Super Bowl? Oh, wow, nice.
Yeah, we did it with
who won?
New York Yachad. It's very, very, very fun, and we watch that Super Bowl and eat, like Carl's Gabby's.
Oh, wow. Nice.
And also, I did a lot of more programming, and I was at camp in Minnesota.
Oh, yeah. And,
for 6 years, and this year, I'm going back, I'm a seventh year.
JJ, you work in the kitchen in Missouri, yeah?
And also, I work in the kitchen with Uzi Meisner, May Meisner.
That's sick.
For those of you who don't know, JJ's a really good cook.
Yeah, this is all my years, all my 6 years.
Wow, that's unreal. I definitely have to say that my favorite was, I mean, Missouri Yachad was obviously the best. JJ and I used to tear up the night activities, you know, whatever.
Yeah, I said that activity too. Yeah, we worked up. So one time, one night activity, so we did the mystery envelope.
Oh, mystery envelope, yeah. Best game.
And also last year, I did something with something wicked. He ate the whole jalapeno pepper.
No way. They had a jalapeno pepper challenge?
Tannins, and I burned my mouth.
That's crazy.
Really bad. But I said, I need a drink.
My favorite night was definitely, I like garbage bag dress-up night. We had to take garbage bags and make costumes out of them. You were Lady Gaga?
There's a costume tape.
I was Batman. Whatever. So my favorite trip was, I did the Yachad cruise that went from Greece to Cyprus.
Yeah, it was like a week long. I did that too.
You guys were there?
I love that too. Good
time. Yeah. Sick. So it was like a week of unlimited food, crazy night activities. We played Let's Make a Deal, and like every other prize, like it was like some of them were like legit prizes, like $100. And then other ones were like, you get a coat hanger. It was just hysterical.
Yeah, that cruise was a lot of fun.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun. Yeah, the Yachad cruise, so much fun. We had great activities that we did on the cruise.
Do you guys have any funny stories you can share about like some of your from any of your Yachad experiences?
Eytan, go first.
I should go first.
I could go for it. Either way, so definitely two of them was. Well, one, you said the pizza man, like that was really a fun time for me. Like I would just get up there. Like one time I was doing a Tarzan and like, it was like me and this girl doing it. And I was like Tarzan. And then like, I pretended like to be on a rope and I jumped off. And then the girl looked at me like when she had to with the pizza man song, you have to go back in reverse and say all the names that you had said. So like when she got up to Tarzan, she like looked at me like, do I have to jump? And I'm like, yeah, you better go jump now. So she's like, whatever, fine. So she went for it. And so that was one. And then another one was like me and like whatever. I used to do this shtick with like one of the me, JJ, and this other girl, Yoki. We did this shtick where we're like, I pretend to be the gingerbread man. And like during cooking stuff, we were doing.
Never get the button.
From Shrek, where it's like, not the gumdrop buttons. Or like, eat me. Whatever. So we used to do that all day.
That's my fun thing that, it's really funny what I did in camp. So in camp, we had a garbage bag bottle fashion thing, and I was like a popular, or famous singer. I was all with cushion tape, and I was Lady Gaga over my head, and then the first take. I went, I said,
you sang in front of everyone?
No, I ran and I slid.
You slid.
Oh, you slid. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't know. Right. I don't know if this is considered a funny story, but
once we're talking about Missouri,
when we had color war, JJ, I don't know if you remember this, but do you remember when we were on the yellow team?
Yeah, I remember that, and I was the drummer.
Exactly, that's what I was talking about. JJ's a really, really good drummer, for those of you guys who didn't know. We're learning a lot of JJ facts here. But JJ's an awesome drummer, so I was helping out with Tom a little bit. And JJ,
I played for a lot of years, like 11 years.
You've been playing the drums for 11 years?
11 years, drumming, I play bongos, I play anything of drumming, and the beatboxing.
That's crazy. I've been trying to learn how to play piano over the past few days. Now that I'm just sitting here. But yeah, so the stomp was really awesome. We had a stomp with all the campers, and JJ came in at the end and rocked it, which was awesome.
Yeah, and we won.
JJ, can you give us a demo or no?
Yes, I could. Right. Yeah.
You have it on you or not? Not here.
Do you have bongos at home?
I do. Yeah, I saw you my thing.
Fine. All right. While he's going to get them, can we do, Mary, you want to get the poll going on whatever?
I have it.
All right, let's go for it. Eytan, what, you also are a coordinator now, right?
Yeah.
How's that been?
It's been really awesome. It kind of gives me it gives me the opportunity. You know, JJ, you go. I'll talk after. Oh,
so JJ, you do the drum demonstration. There's also polls going around right now on my experience with Yachad has been a friend, supporter, community. All right, fine, whatever, JJ, go. I don't want to. JJ, you got it?
Yeah, I got it too.
All right, let's do it. I'm down for the drum roll.
Okay, so I'm ready.
Oh.
That's the beat.
Nice.
I always did that every beat.
That was the beat. It's crazy how you remember that.
Yeah, oh, only the beat. I can do any kind of beat. I can do rhythm, I can do that. That's it.
Yeah, it was really fun.
Okay.
It's great. Wait, Eytan, what were you saying about your...
Yeah, so going back to the position as coordinator, it's kind of really cool because I don't know how many of you, I guess they'll find out from the survey that was just sent out, but I don't know how many of you guys have been involved in Yachad in the past. But for those of you who haven't been involved in Yachad in the past, there are a bunch of Shabbatonim. What?
Oh, fine. The results are fine.
Oh, yeah, there we go. Okay. So 33% of you haven't done anything with regards to Yachad in the past. So I guess this could be really cool for you guys to find out, to get opportunities to come join, our experience and our family. I think it's really, really cool. It definitely, is able to impact a lot of other people and also impact you in a really tremendous way. And I think it's also tons of fun. So basically what I was saying before is that there are a bunch of Shabbatonim that go on throughout the year. So I'm involved in senior Yachad, which is one of the division. It goes by ages. So it's basically high school age, a little bit older, usually until they're like mid-20s. And it's really such a cool experience to be able to get together for 10 Shabbatonim a year, 11 Shabbatonim a year, whatever it is, and some programming on Sunday. For all these things to like go around and actually have the opportunity to get close with a bunch of Yachad members and a bunch of different advisors and a bunch of different high schoolers and kind of have that opportunity to kind of just be myself in a fun and friendly like environment. I think it's just like a really nice opportunity.
All right, cool. All right, I don't know if he's unmuted yet, but I know that we have a very special guest here. He is unmuted. Okay, cool. The one and only director of college level engagement, Avi Feather, also known as Feathers, in the house.
I think I'm only known as Feathers by one person on this chat. So shout out to the producer, I guess. Is that a Hoover Walker? Can we give a shout out to a boo?
Yeah. Yeah. I thought it was nationally known.
No, but you just made it. So thanks for embarrassing me in front of all the, I don't know, 50 people in this chat.
Now it's national.
Now it is.
All right, cool. Yeah. All right, Avi, take it away.
Yeah, I just want to thank everybody for being on the chat. It's really impressive. It's a great crew. JJ, where'd you go, man? Where'd your video go? Yeah, Zack, let me ask you. What was your experience
with
us on a show of its own?
What has my experience been?
Yeah.
So I've done a few Shabbatones. I've done one or two community Shabbatones, and I've done some where you go to like different hotels, and it's definitely a lot of fun. Like you get paired up like one-on-one with a Yachad participant, and you kind of just chill together with him. Like you get to eat, you chill by meals together, sick food, and you get to, I mean, when you're with the community ones, like you get to meet a lot of the residents and you just have a fun time. I think they do like two or three circle times, which are a lot of great shtick. And like it's just a ton of games, these circle times, like a variety of games. It's really fun. And then you have a lot of free swag, a lot of free food. It's just overall a great vibe. Everyone's really nice and friendly.
Nice. Yeah. So something I've actually been working on a lot is struggling with the challenge that we really can't have Shabbatones right now. You know, when this coronavirus first started creeping up, we were thinking like maybe we keep them going, but just, you know, see if we can make them a little bit smaller, see if communities will still have us. But we've pretty much had to make the decision, unfortunately, to discontinue all Shabbatons for the foreseeable future, which has actually kind of been pretty rough for a lot of us.
Yeah. I mean, it seems like the entire country's kind of on like some sort of like everything's been put on hold and like switching to virtual.
Yeah, so we've actually done a really cool job. Speaking of virtual, we've actually shifted almost the entire Yachad to virtual. I don't know. I'm curious if you've heard of anything that we're doing virtual. It's really, really, really interesting stuff, which we never did before. But it's like a whole organization switched to virtual and doing new programming we never did previously.
Wow. I mean, I saw like some advertisements for like comedy show night and like yoga meditation. But yeah, that's kind of like generic stuff.
Yeah, you know what? Can I toss it at you, JJ, for a second? Have you done any of the virtual programming?
I did last night, yesterday at 12. We did a let's make a deal. We did that.
Oh wow.
With Dove Cat. We did that. Yachad version.
Nice.
Yeah, I think with Dove Cats, my dad was actually telling me today, like, I might try and get him to do like a big YU event. Like I heard he like runs fun game show nights.
Yeah, I think cool. YU too, I think. I don't know, but
yeah. Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. So then I'll tell you a new program actually, Zach. Something that we're rolling out now in Yachad is actually a really interesting program, which we had kind of on the back burner. It's a program which, you know, us in Yachad, we have ideas, and sometimes you have a program which you want to roll out. We probably intended on rolling this thing out in a few months from now, maybe for the start of the, you know, September, maybe January 2021.
Okay,
with the coronavirus, we actually rolled something out pretty much in a few weeks. We got something from concept where we weren't quite ready to roll with it to actually live, you know, running today. I'm actually going to screen share if that's okay with you and let everyone see what it is.
Let's go for it.
So, yeah, just give me a second here, right here. You'll tell me if you guys can see my screen. Someone give me a thumbs up there if you're seeing it.
I don't see your screen yet.
I'm not seeing it yet.
Let's see why this is going. Do you guys
here,
see it now?
You got it.
Yeah, you got it.
Okay, so this is actually a website. If you guys see up in the top left corner, you see it's called Swirly.
What's that?
I'll tell you the story behind this. It's actually fascinating. Swirly is the name of a Yachad member who is Yachad member. I'm sorry?
I'm not Swirly.
You're not Swirly. Your name is Jonah. Or Yossi,
no, I know Swirly.
Jonah.
I know him.
Oh, yes, yeah, Swirly? Yeah.
Yeah, Swirly, yeah.
So Swirly was in Camp Hask, actually, which is an organization which
we
partner with. We're very close with. We're friends with everybody in Hask and Yachad. We obviously are all doing the same, similar, you know, good stuff for Klal Yisrael. And a Yachad counselor, Hask counselor, decided that Swirly, this, you know, young man in Hask and many people of all ages in the Yachad or Hask orbit would benefit from having some sort of chat feature, probably most similar to Facebook chat, Facebook Messenger, but it's not always available. It's not always something that they can take part in for whatever reason. And we created our own. It's named after Swirly, like you see up over here. And for all intents and purposes, I'm going to chat with myself for 1 minute because sometimes I got no friends and I just talk to myself.
Yeah, I love giving myself pump up speeches.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna speak to myself and I'm gonna hand my phone to my fiance, actually, my Kala over here sitting next to me. And I'm going to have her chat with me. And we'll just have a little conversation, actually, on Swirly. We'll see if we can get that popped up. It actually might not pop up right there. But basically, we can chat. We can talk back and forth. See if you can figure that out. I'm sorry, I didn't test that.
Mazel tov.
Thank you very much. Go ahead, take that. Yeah, basically, it for all intents and purposes, it's a chat app like anyone else. You can have group chats here. Someone's typing back to me. Hi, Avi. Thanks, Ellie. You see, we got group chats going on here.
Are you texting with neighbors because of Corona? Like, you just want to, like, you're like.
Yeah, great question. So the way it works is that nobody who you're chatting with, I'm going to end the screen share, by the way. Just I'm gonna be able to see my face here. That's my friends who just got married. Yeah. You guys want to see that?
Oh wow, that was tough.
Thank you. Yeah, a lot of simchas. For all intents and purposes, one of the challenges of social media and Facebook chat and WhatsApp chat and things like that is that people don't know who they're chatting with, and it can become a little bit dangerous. You know, like you can really be talking to anybody, and it's a little bit like scary in that way. So one of the features of this is that only people who are verified are on the app. So there's no chance that you're speaking to somebody who's catfishing or impersonating other people. I don't know if you've had any experiences like that online. Maybe you can talk to Zach. You're kind of like a worldly guy.
Yeah. I one time got a Facebook message from Zachary Greenberg, and I was like, did I message myself? And then I realized that I was added to a group chat called Zachary Greenberg, full of other Zachary Greenbergs from across the planet. So I don't know who any of them were.
Crazy.
Yeah, but that wasn't like such, but definitely hear like the fact that, you know, you get a lot of random people could like send you spam stuff that like could lead to viruses. Like my sister last week, like opened up this like random message and like her phone shut down for a little bit. And like, we had to like go to the store and fix it. Identity theft is not a joke.
Can I tell you, speaking of random messages, can I hold up my cell phone to the screen? Can you guys see that?
Yeah.
Can you guys read that?
Get me in this app. You've been thinking about this forever.
Yeah.
This is literally a message. You see the timestamp on that? I just got that message at 10:30. Shout out to one of our advisors. They can identify themselves in the chat. I'm not going to out you if you don't want to be outed, my man.
Okay,
outed your gender, but you can shout yourself out in the chat if you want. But this is something that we've actually seen a lot of excitement about. I'll give you a profile, buddy. You can identify yourself, but that's a guy who I met. He was a counselor. Was it in Morasha, my friend? I believe it was. We met in Camp Morasha. And then he was in deterioration on Aleph Shanabet, maybe even third year. Could be wrong on that. And he's been an advisor of ours. He's texting me LOL. And
what does LOL stand for?
To that other advisor, my fellow West Hempsteadite, a young lady who's texting me right now saying, yes, represent. Why don't everybody who's in this Srilly app shout themselves out in the chat right there, because I'm just going to show you guys another message. This is another one coming in. Somebody who's already on the chat, who's on Srilly.
Avi, how does one sign up for a Srilly account?
Yeah.
Great question. So the truth is that because the Srilly app is designed to protect people's identities, for right now, the way we're doing it is through the Yachad website. And it's a good opportunity for me to just encourage everybody. I'm actually going to drop it right into the chat right now.
Awesome.
If you go to yachad.org/yachad-on-demand, kind of like on demand, you guys can follow that link. And there's actually tons of programming going on in Yachad. That's all sorts of virtual stuff. So we got comedy clubs. We got like the things that JJ was talking about. We got so many different things going on that you can join like on Zoom. And then one specific feature is called the virtual buddies. And that's basically like being on the phone, but just one-on-one. One person, and that's
I do that too.
Yeah.
And also I'm doing cooking with Rafi Cooper.
Oh, cooking, nice.
Yep.
Yeah. Wow. It's gonna be a good thing there.
All right. All right, Feathers. Thanks so much for sharing all these great informations and fun ways. You're able to post like any of the, I mean, we all got the link to the Yachad on demand. So everyone feel free to check it out. And hopefully we can all, you know, even though Yachad's going viral now, like get as many people involved as possible. Cause things that we're all like kind of confined to our homes, but it's definitely still able to be social, have some great fun. And this is Yachad's definitely an amazing way to do so.
You got it. Thanks for having us.
Thanks, right.
Yeah. See you around. Okay, so wanted to move on to the last quick topic is Makor, I just wanted to hear from JJ. So I know that you're in the Makor program. You can tell me a little about your schedule and what it's like.
My schedule in Makor, we do in the morning, we do this Gemara, but we do a Masechet. We're doing Masechet Bava Mesia, and also in Makor, we We go like outing, we go fun jobs like for after 3 years. And I'm in my third year program in Makor now. And this year in May, I'm graduating from my year.
Oh, wow. Mazel tov.
Yeah, so about the team max, the NYU max.
Oh, yeah, aren't you the manager of the basketball team?
So I'm the assistant manager of the team. I got a Maccabi's kippah right here. Uh-huh. And my first Skyline half flames shirt. I was there, I was cutting the neck, the hoop. It was so fun, my job. I was wearing a tie, pants, a button-down shirt. But then the coach is Eddie Steinman.
Wow. That's crazy. You know, really he bad. Just won. He won in the entire Division III Coach of the Year.
The last game, I was canceled without the crisis.
Right.
So,
right.
But
it was a great season, though.
In Cologne still, I went there before, Gemara. And then we go for lunch, and after that, and then we.
Wait, didn't you just finish a CM on Gemara?
We did Bava Kama. It's right over here. I have it right here. This is Bava Kama.
Not nice.
This is a Sefer to present.
Yeah. Right here. Wow. Unreal. Mazel tov, man.
I have a lot more things. From the core, and I want to say a few more things. So in the core, we blended with YU because we do clubs, like in nighttime, we do clubs. Clubs are very fun. Yeah, we do wood carving club, baking club. I love baking and cooking. Live my passion.
Improv.
Yeah, improv, and I'm the co-president of the improv club.
Whoa. Wow. I didn't know I was dealing with the president. That's unreal.
Yeah, and also there's more clubs I'm taking this year. This year I'm taking Machine Learning Club, and also Real Estate Club.
Real Estate?
Yeah.
Nice.
And Networking Club.
Eytan, are you in this many clubs?
I am not in that many clubs. JJ, I don't know how you have time for all those clubs.
I did.
You're a legend.
I love going to events.
Yeah.
It's the best. Announcing all your classes.
But playing by you is the best.
I'm actually working on a committee right now to fix we're amending the Constitution and, like, trying to fix a lot of stuff, like, inconsistencies and, like, clarifications. And we're in discussion about adding a core representative to
And also one more thing. Someone that's coming now.
Daniel Mullen is on the committee.
His name, my professor, is Dr. Grisman. He said, I saw on the chat just now. He said, I'm in the psychology class.
Oh, wow. Wow, unreal. All right, I wanted to cut to, I'm with my friend Aline, right?
Aline, yeah.
That was my next guess. Whatever. going on the similar topic of Chesed during Corona. So Alini, whatever Aline, that's pretty much what I said. Is she's in charge of START, which has been running events virtually. You think you could tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah. Also, Maxo is here. He's my co-president.
What is that?
Yeah. Can you unmute Maxo?
Yeah. I gotta find him. if I find him, or if. Miriam gets him first.
Thanks, Zach.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Wow.
That was me. All right, cool. You think you guys could talk about STAR for a sec, for a little bit?
Yeah.
What is STAR? What does that mean?
STAR's a great club. Basically, normally when we're at school, so we run weekly science lessons in 11 classrooms around Washington Heights. But due to the school closures, unfortunately, a lot of students, as you know, are home from school, which is a big burden on parents who are trying to juggle their jobs while also trying to monitor their children. So this year, actually a few weeks ago, we decided to create this amazing new partnership where STAR's going to be working with Bundle. Bundle is an organization that basically provides childcare services virtually for professionals so they can get more work done and their kids can be looked after. Normally it's a service that costs money, but during the COVID-19 pandemic, so Bundle has decided to partner with us. They're offering a free service. We're basically, they're providing childcare to people whose kids are at home during COVID-19. So Alini, do you want to explain how YU students can get involved?
Wait, Alini, yes, before you start, I just want to know, where are you from exactly?
Me? I'm from Brazil. Yeah.
Classic. Where in Brazil? I'm just kidding, it's not classic.
São Paulo.
I don't know anyone from Brazil. Yeah, nice to meet you from Brazil. Are you there now?
Yes.
Wow. All right, cool. All right, fine. So yeah, wait, what were you saying? I'm sorry for cutting you off.
So actually Bundle was needing a lot of help because they had a lot of parents signed up because it's been really hard for parents. So they had like 200 parents in the wait list and they really needed volunteers. So they got in contact with, like we got in contact with them, they got in contact with us. And Bundle made it really, really simple for us to help. So basically, there is a sign-up link that I'm sending right now in the chat.
Amazing.
So the sign-up link takes literally 2 seconds. And then Kayla, who is the CEO of Bundle, she will get in contact with you. She will call you for 5 to 10 minutes to explain everything, how it works. And then you're done. And it's like they made it super easy for volunteers. They send you a whole lesson plan, like ready. Like you need even less than 15 minutes to go over it and like be ready to teach the kids. So it's really, really simple. She made it so effective. Like, she's amazing. She made it super effective and just super efficient. And it's just really, really easy to join. Uh-huh. And they really, really need help. And we have a lot of free time. So if we could use like 1 hour of your day, like the commitment is very low. She asked us to help twice a month. Like twice a month is nothing for an hour. So it's 2 hours in 30 days. Like that's literally nothing. But it really means a lot to these parents because they're really struggling.
All right, cool. Thanks a lot, Aline. Really appreciate it. Alini, whatever. My bad. Okay, so you didn't hear that. I got it right. Okay. All right. Last segment before the Q&A. So as always, we're going to continue with story time and with Zack. And this time we're going to feature Uhuva from episode 3. She's doing a throw, Zack, and she's going to pick a random story from my Google Doc. And let's see which one she goes for.
All right. So I'm going to pick the story called Got Locked in a Freezer Waiters.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right. All right. That was a crazy story. So back in the day, I was in Missouri Waiters. I actually did Yachad first month, and then second month I did Waiters. And like since I did Yachad my first month, when I showed up month 2, I didn't know like how the whole kitchen system ran. So, you know, I was just like, JJ was there. So there's like, they have like a huge freezer.
I made a thousand people.
It's crazy.
Thousands. Yeah, it's very good. They get my passion.
So they had a ton of ice pops in the freezer, which I love to steal. So I one time like went to get an ice pop, but then accidentally, it was Friday night, and then the door shut behind me. And I was just like, oh my God, I didn't know how to open it up. And like, it's kind of like soundproof. So I was just like, JJ shut me in. That's apparently how, that's why I got locked in. I don't know why you did that to me, but all right. So whatever. So JJ apparently locked me in or it shut by itself. I'm to be determined. But so like, I was a little bit nervous. I was like probably in there for like 10 minutes. So I was just like banging on the door. And then finally, like, I started like, you know, I like it was Shabbos, but I thought it was a life and death situation. So I just started pulling out plugs. I don't really know if it worked or not because it was still pretty cold, but eventually I was still banging. And then finally someone like let me out, but it was definitely a scary experience, but you know what, worked out in the end.
Have you ever?
What?
Are you scared of ice pops now?
No, but I guess I'm a little bit scared of freezer. I actually learned how to, you just have to push the button, but it was like in a tricky way. Like, I don't know why it wasn't just a door handle. It's like you have to like push it up. I don't know. I learned how to do it after. JJ, I don't know why you were holding the door shut on me.
But I was not sneaking in. But I look in the kitchen. I got some free stuff in there. I could. But Chef Uzi knows. And I'm gonna get some free cookies, free stuff. But I saw something. I saw someone like in the freezer, and it was Zack.
All right, cool. Fine. So we're going to wrap it up with a quick Q&A. If anyone's got any questions, feel free to raise your hand. More than happy to answer them. All right, CJ Glucksman's going to kick it off. CJ, go.
Am I?
Yeah.
Hey, CJ.
Hey, CJ. Right.
Zack, hi. What am I supposed to be doing now? Sorry, I was not paying attention.
There's a lot of sign-up stuff.
Am I asking a question?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, Zack, my question for you, if you could, I know you're super into Disney,
right?
So if you could be a Disney character, which one would you be?
If like not like which right. one I like not my sole Disney character, like which one do I want to be?
Yeah, yeah, like if you could choose to be Disney character.
I guess so. Aladdin's pretty cool. Like he like he's got a flying carpet. He's got a monkey Abu. It's he's cute.
I have the keeper. I have the keeper.
What else? Yeah, he's got a Yachad. Yeah, he's got a Yachad keeper.
I have a
he's got an arch nemesis who's trying to kill him. That always keeps life exciting. I don't know what more you want. You know, it's that's fun. All right. Danny Malou, I saw your hand was up. What's up?
How's it going, Zack?
I was hoping for like a princess or something.
That's it. That's all you got.
No. So, all right, Zack. So, first question is, who is the Senate?
Who is the Senate?
And
the
yeah. Senate. Okay. No. Yeah, well, actually, that was just a fake question. The real question is like this, Zack. You and I love Star Wars, but I want to ask you specifically, who is your favorite
Star Wars
villain? Not character, specifically villain.
Villain?
Yeah.
Kylo Ren's pretty awesome, but Darth Vader is definitely the best one. Like, it's kind of like his music's awesome.
Yeah.
I am your father.
I know, but I thought you'd say Palpatine because you're always saying his line.
No. Oh, yeah. Palpatine's the best to quote, but like, yeah, but Darth Vader's the GOAT. Like, I don't know. He beat me up in Disney World. It doesn't really get crazier than that.
He did.
I don't know if you guys were on that other episode. I talked about that story, I think, right?
Yeah, that was a crazy story, honestly.
Yeah. All right, cool. All right. I guess last question. If not, we'll wrap it up for the night. Wait, also new thing. I need to get subscribers on YouTube, so I'm gonna post my link. So on top of all the other links that you have to sign up for, this is another one. This one also sign up for. But yeah,
okay. I have a YouTube channel too. You can subscribe to me too.
Okay, post the link.
Hello.
Okay. Cool. All right. So any last questions? If not, all right. Oh, wait, I see someone.
Any questions for me, by the way?
I just unmuted someone.
There's yeah, hi.
Chat. Oh, it's Elka. Okay, what's going on?
I think the proper question is, if you could be a Disney princess, which one would you be?
Eytan, you want to take that one, JJ?
No, that was a you question.
I'll do that.
Fine. I think... I don't know. Okay, fine. Probably Rapunzel's pretty cool. I'm not going to lie. Like, she's got dreams. I had a dream. She's got a great voice. Her hair is awesome. She's got flowers in her hair. Yeah, it's pretty awesome. I don't know. She's got definitely the coolest boyfriend. Flynn Rider's a beast. And he's got a pet lizard. Doesn't get better than that. So, yeah, that'd be my answer. JJ, which princess would you want to be?
The princess I'm gonna be I have a dream too, by the way.
Really?
Yeah, I have a dream too, yes. And I'll say Belle from Beauty and the Beast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, you like?
But she was in love with the Beast.
Yeah, it's a good choice. Yeah. Frozen Solid likes it. All right, cool. All right, Eytan, you want to give your last answer, and then we'll wrap it up?
Yeah, I kind of feel bad saying the same thing as JJ, but the answer has to be Belle.
What? Why are you always copying everyone? Did you also show me in the freezer?
There's not even a close second.
Okay.
Those pizza pops.
Okay, ice pops are scary. All right, cool. All right, thanks a lot for watching, guys. Hopefully, hopefully
it looks like a lot of people
saying no. That's a general question for me,
yeah,
by the way.
A lot of people
and
like no.
I have a question for me. And they have questions for me, but.
All right, yeah. I mean, definitely, like, I think the main takeaway tonight is that even though it's Corona and, like, we're at home, there's still a lot of opportunities to do chesed and get involved. So definitely do that.
And Zach, do you see my keeper? Aladdin?
Wow, that's a great keeper. Is that a Yachad keeper, or is that just a, that's just your keeper?
This is my keeper. I thought you're Aladdin.
Wow, that's hot.
And we're done in five. Four,
whoa.
Three,
it's like two,
one.